This is Hiyoshi Station on the Tokyu Toyoko Line, Meguro Line, and Shin Yokohama Line. Another line that serves this station is the Yokohama Municipal Subway Green Line, which we'll be introducing today. To coincide with the opening of the Green Line, new underground ticket gates were installed on the Tokyu Line, allowing passengers to transfer underground. There is a temporary fence jutting out from the corner, presumably because there are frequent head-on collisions between passengers. Yokohama is a city south of Tokyo with a population of approximately 3.8 million. The Green Line runs from Hiyoshi Station to Nakayama Station. The entire line opened at once in 2008. It is the second longest Yokohama Municipal Subway line, after the Blue Line. At 13.1 kilometers, or 8.14 miles, it is quite short for a Japanese subway line. On the other hand, the Blue Line runs from Azamino Station to Shonandai Station, and is 40.4 kilometers, or 25.1 miles long. The two lines are very different. The fare to Nakayama Station is a mere 310 yen, or about $2. Considering the distance is 13.1 kilometers, or 8.14 miles, it's quite expensive. Although the ticket gates for the Tokyu Line and Green Line are not connected, they are opposite each other, making transfers easy. When I got off the platform, a train bound for Hiyoshi had just arrived. It was quite hectic, with people rushing to transfers, rushing for the escalators. Passengers were leaving fairly quickly. But this was around 6:30 a.m. It wasn't the peak of rush hour. And here is the Green Line carriage. You can see that it's quite small compared to the people in the reflection. The pantograph is also this size, half buried in the carriage. And this carriage's shape tapers at the top. This shape is very different from that of Blue Line carriages. This explains why different standards were adopted for the Green Line, even though they are both Yokohama Municipal Subway lines, and why the congestion problem has become so severe. While the Blue Line uses standard railway standards, the Green Line uses a linear motor system. This method miniaturizes the motor by replacing some of the motor's components with plates between the rails. These plates are called reaction plates and are laid everywhere the trains run. The magnetic force between these plates and the car's motor causes the car to move. When you hear the word linear, you might think of linear motor cars, but linear just means straight, not levitating. Other subway lines that use linear motors, including the Green Line, do not have levitating cars. While the adoption of linear motors typically only allows for miniaturization around the motor, it also generally miniaturizes the car body, reducing the cross-sectional area of the tunnel. The top of the car body is tapered, and the pantograph is half buried in the car body, so that it can fit snugly into the circular tunnel. This tunnel is called a shield tunnel, and is created by digging into the ground with a cylindrical machine with a cutter at the end, and then adding concrete blocks from the inside to create the tunnel. Since it does not affect the surface, except for areas where machinery is moved in and out, it is suitable for construction deep underground or on privately owned land. Comparing the Blue Line and Green Line, the tunnel diameter has been reduced by approximately 17%, thanks to the adoption of a linear motor system and smaller car bodies. The cross-sectional area has also been reduced by more than 30%, resulting in a corresponding reduction in construction costs. Furthermore, since regular railways run on friction between the wheels and rails, there is a limit to the gradient to prevent slippage. In contrast, linear motor systems run on the power of reaction plates and car body components, so steeper gradients can be set. The Green Line runs through hilly areas on the outskirts of Yokohama, and the steep gradients that only a linear motor system could handle led to the adoption of a linear motor system. Furthermore, the Green Line was originally positioned as a route connecting the suburbs of Yokohama. Since it was intended to operate independently rather than as a direct connection to existing lines, it was decided that different standards would be acceptable. When the route was first conceived, it effectively connected lines in the Yokohama area, and it seems like it would have been a fairly convenient line if the entire line had opened. In the end, only the section that corresponds to the Green Line opened, but its role is still the same today. By the way, before the entire blue line opened, the route was planned to be simpler than it is now. Two lines branch off around Kohokunin town, one heading towards Yokohama on a route similar to the current blue line, and the other heading towards Tsurumi on a route similar to the green line. It only intersects with the Tokyu line between Hiyoshi and Tsunashima, and there is no station, so it is less convenient. It also does not connect to Nakayama Station. Due to the nature of the line, it was expected that the volume of traffic would be lower than lines connecting the city center and the suburbs, so a linear motor system with small cars would be sufficient. In summary, the factors that contributed to this were an independent operation format, low traffic demand, and the ability to handle steep gradients. Here's what Sentei Minami Station looked like around 7:30 a.m. The busiest section of the Green Line is between Hiyoshi Honcho and Hiyoshi. This train runs during the morning rush hour, but with so many passengers getting off, it doesn't appear particularly crowded. This is because many passengers at Sentei Minami Station are transferring to the Blue Line heading towards Yokohama. Neighboring Sentei Kita Station also seems surprisingly less crowded. When the 7:37 a.m. train left Sentei Kita Station, there were still seats available in the last car, enough for everyone to sit down. This train arrives at Hiyoshi Honcho Station, one stop before Hiyoshi Station, at 7:46 a.m. Few people make it to the very last car, and it's crowded enough that you can still stand comfortably. This is because the traffic flow to the ticket gates at Hiyoshi Station, the final stop, is towards the front, so the front to middle cars of the train are so crowded that passengers are backed up in front of the doors. The next train is the same. While the front and middle cars are quite crowded, there is quite a bit of space at the very end. Not only is there space next to the doors, but there are also a few seats available. This is a bit strange, as it's the morning rush hour, and any seats that are available would probably be filled quickly. Here's what the train looked like when it arrived at Hiyoshi Station. Passengers heading towards the ticket gates from the rear cars are packed, so there is a long queue around the escalator. There are three escalators on this side, one of which is for outbound travel only, so it seems like there isn't enough capacity when the train arrives. Even when the ticket gates begin to open up, the Tokyo Line station ahead is crowded, slowing the flow of people. Although the number of passengers has been increasing year by year, this does not mean that the congestion rate is increasing accordingly. In fact, the Green Line's congestion rate has shown a dramatic improvement over the past few years. Before the spread of COVID-19, the congestion rate at the busiest section in fiscal 2019 was 163%. Compared to the guidelines set by the Ministry of Land, Infrastructure, Transport, and Tourism, it's a bit difficult to read a newspaper comfortably. In fiscal 2020, the congestion rate on all lines has dropped sharply due to the impact of the pandemic. The same is true for the Green Line, which has fallen from 163% to 109%, returning to almost capacity. The rush hour has eased considerably, with passengers now able to board by holding onto straps or the handlebars around the doors. Since then, while congestion rates on other lines have increased as the pandemic has subsided, the congestion rate on the Green Line has been declining since peaking in fiscal 2021 and 2022. This is due to the increase in trains from 4 to 6 cars that was underway during this period. Initially, all trains on the Green Line were 4-car trains to reduce construction costs. Although the facilities were designed to accommodate 6 cars, unused platforms were partitioned off and no platform doors were installed. At the time of planning, once the growth in passenger numbers had stabilized, the most congested section was between Hiyoshi and Hiyoshi Honcho. Approximately 18,000 passengers were expected to use the service per hour on this section. Each 4-car train has a capacity of 584 people, and with 21 trains operating per hour, the congestion rate would be 145%. This would allow passengers to spread out their newspapers and read them, and the rush hour wouldn't be too severe. The number of trains could be increased to a maximum of 30 per hour, giving a maximum transport capacity of just over 26,000 passengers per hour. With a capacity of about 1.5 times that, it was expected that this would be sufficient. As passengers increased after the line opened, the congestion rate rose to 163% in fiscal 2019. To improve this situation, additional trains were introduced and trains were extended to 6 cars, in addition to increasing the frequency of trains. To expand from 4 to 6 cars, 2 intermediate cars were added to some trains. The original carriages had small partitions at the ends of the seats, and in some cases even used transparent panels, but the added carriages have larger partitions with darker panels, reducing the feeling of oppression felt by people sitting on the edges. Six-car trains also have conspicuous stickers on the top of the carriages. This fall, trains arriving at Hiyoshi Station between 7:30 a.m. and 8 a.m. were increased to 6 cars, steadily progressing measures to alleviate congestion. However, due to the structure of Hiyoshi Station, congestion is concentrated in the front cars. This is because the Green Line ticket gates and other facilities are biased towards the east side of the station in order to fit the ticket gates for the Tokyu Line and Green Line in a limited amount of space. As a result, 4-car trains stop at the very back of the platform rather than in the middle. As seen earlier, this leads to the very last cars being empty, slightly reducing the effectiveness of increasing the number of cars to 6. It would have been better if the Green Line ticket gates and other facilities could be designed so that they sandwiched the Tokyu Line ticket gates, but the narrow roads on the west side of Hiyoshi Station are a problem. Although stations have been improved in line with the expansion of Tokyu's routes, the location of bus terminals and other facilities means that buses have to enter the narrow alleys in front of the stations. Traffic congestion has become an issue, and measures such as making some roads one-way have recently been taken, so looking at it again, it seems impossible. Also, because trains during the busiest times have been prioritized to be 6-car, there are still 4-car trains remaining, mainly around this time. With the spread of staggered work hours, trains are quite crowded even around 8 a.m. It's possible that the 4-car trains after the busiest times are actually the busiest. Also, on the Blue Line, where congestion is gradually increasing, the timetable is being revised to prevent trains on both lines from departing and arriving at the same time at major stations. It looks like congestion prevention measures on both lines will continue for some time to come. Thank you for watching.